BBOR, Black Box Online Radio, coming to you from West Virginia. Today we're going to be revisiting the disappearance of Maura Murray. This is one of the most widely discussed missing persons cases that has entered into the internet sphere, if you're going to look at that angle. And it's been a while since we've talked about Maura Murray, but I will always remember that I read a blog once that talked about there could be clues in the movie Bottle Rocket, directed by Wes Anderson, that tie into the Maura Murray case. To give a little bit of a foundation before we really get into the hard discussion, Maura Murray, of course, went missing in February of 2004 after crashing her car into a snowbank in Haverhill, New Hampshire. Now, I read this on a blog, and this was the first time that I had ever heard about the movie Bottle Rocket. I had looked for a copy in the past, and I was unsuccessful. But right now, we're doing a free trial of CBS All Access. I just decided to look at the movies that they had there, and Bottle Rocket was one that was right at the top, alphabetical order. So I decided to watch that one the other day, and I thought we could examine the possibility of clues being tied into the disappearance of Maura Murray. What I would say about this one is also giving it the precursor that I'm not sure if the missing Maura Murray guys, Lance and Tim, have covered this. They are perhaps the most famous podcast that has gone through the disappearance of Maura Murray in the recent years. I used to follow that series. I stopped listening about after episode 29 or 30 or maybe 31. That was the thing. I forgot where I was. I lost my place. And every time I tried to jump back into an episode, I was really missing a lot of material. But there were some big exceptions that I took to with that series. And I've talked about that one in a previous upload. And if you would like to listen to that after this one, I highly recommend you check out our upload on Maura Murray and the Media. I'll include a link to that here. What I would say about this one is, if we're going to talk about the film Bottle Rocket, which features Owen Wilson and Luke Wilson, and, but you know, it's a Wes Anderson film. Some directors really like to work with a certain group of people. If I didn't know that Owen Wilson was in this film, I wouldn't have recognized him. He has very short hair, took on a very different type of personality. But as far as clues regarding the disappearance of Maura Murray, I was reading this blog, and it said that Maura Murray was heavily inspired by the film Bottle Rocket. She talked to her friends about the film Bottle Rocket being one of her favorite movies. And in this film, you have three people trying to run away and start a new life. A lot of people have been very critical of anyone who suggested that Maura Murray could still be alive or that she started a different life somewhere. Once again, as we said, after crashing her car into a snowbank in February of 2004, she disappeared. She vanished. And one of the theories out there is that Maura went to Canada for their variety of possibilities. But some people are like, Maura Murray was somebody who got caught ordering pizza with a stolen credit card. She was caught stealing makeup at West Point and had to be kicked out of the school. She was not a mastermind of any proportion. How would she be able to execute such a flawless escape? I mean, one possibility is maybe someone was doing all the planning for her. Maybe someone who was driving a red truck that had wood paneling on the backside. I don't know. Or maybe this isn't the case of anyone who is escaping the United States of America and isn't secretly living in Canada. But the reason why I wanted to talk about this one was after watching the film Bottle Rocket, I don't know how anyone could possibly watch this movie and use it as an inspiration to plan a runaway, a disappearance, to leave and start a new life, because I don't like to give away spoilers, but that's only the first 25 minutes of the film, and it's unsuccessful. It's like, not to mention, as we said, it's a comedy, and if you're going to be looking at how to run away and start your life anew based on a Wes Anderson comedy, it's probably not going to work. But No, it's a tale of an unsuccessful getaway attempt. And it's done in such a obviously farcical and laugh out loud approach. I don't know how anyone could possibly be inspired by that. After I read that one blog years ago, and I couldn't even find it, I tried to look for the website that I had read that on, and I also had looked in the past. Are other people talking about this? Has anyone watched this movie and sort of seen any particular clues? I thought it was going to be something about how you would have a person who got into a car crash and then they disappeared. Because to answer the question, could somebody who got caught stealing makeup, or could somebody who got caught ordering pizza and subs with a stolen credit card plan a flawless disappearance? I began to think for a second, years ago, mind you, that what if they did just watch a movie and they get the idea? But I think a lot of the things associated with Maura Murray running away and starting a new life really tied into the possibility that around the time of a major breakdown she had, the UMass student Patrit Vassy was involved with a hit-and-run incident that he was hit by someone's car, run over, spent a month in a coma. And a lot of people were composing the theory that Maura Murray was indeed alive, living in Canada. Some guy wrote a book called True Crime Addict. We don't say his name on this channel, but he had talked about the tandem driver theory a lot, and they were proposing that Maura did indeed run over the student Patrit Vassy, and that she was in Canada waiting out the statute of limitations so that she could never be prosecuted for any of the incidents that would tie into, or any of the crimes that could be associated with this hit and run incident. A lot of people and a lot of the investigators have really gone into some of those details. And I would not only cite, even if you go beyond Lance and Tim, John Smith had a lot to say about that. And at the time, I mean, he had some wavering things to say about the Vassy hit, but it seemed like he had pulled away from that. And John Smith was also an investigator in the case of Maura Murray, who was very passionate that it was a genuine accident, because one of the eyewitnesses, or it's not even an eyewitness, an ear witness, that's right, someone heard the crash who lived nearby, said that Maura Murray's car accelerated when it was hitting a tree, meaning that the person who had crashed the car was doing it intentionally. But what John Smith really contributed was by saying that the accident reconstructionist went through it, and that car did not hit a tree. The damage was caused by hitting a snowbank. So, meaning that this was the case of an accidental, well, it's a pure accident, more or less. When you look at the disappearance of Maura Murray, there are mostly four possibilities that could have happened. The first one is that Maura Murray crashed her car, took off running, ended up in the woods and passed away, succumbing to the elements, freezing to death. That's number one, and which we would call, I guess, accidental death. Number two is that, like her father said, some dirtbag snatched her. Fred Murray has talked about that from the beginning. And that she got into a vehicle with somebody, and that person did something that ended her life. It doesn't have to be an opportunistic serial killer. It's just that person could have had some altercation with Maura, and that ended her life. The third possibility, which is very rarely talked about, is that Maura committed suicide shortly after. Prior to the disappearance, Maura Murray had, of course, been calling places in the White Mountains, even calling places in Stowe, Vermont, asking if she could stay there. Places like resorts, hotels. And based on some of the items that Maura had purchased, and I did a whole upload talking about the alcohol, saying the alcohol is the biggest clue in this, that Maura Murray had visited a liquor store, purchased some alcohol, and you're just going to find conflicting reports about this. One blog did a very nice breakdown about saying that there are just two different accounts in all of the literature surrounding Maura Murray. And it's been a while since I've looked at those things, but I believe that the one we were talking about was that she purchased a six-pack of wine coolers, a bottle of vodka, and a bottle of Kahlua. And, of course, that's the ingredients that you would use to make a Black Russian. Maura Murray was known to drink Black Russians. I'm a little hazy on that exact detail, but, and the box of Franzia wine, the bottle of vodka might be the thing that was added in fictitiously because Mora was so famously known to drink Black Russians, but there was a bottle of Franzia wine in the backseat of her car. And in that other upload that I mentioned, alcohol is the biggest clue, we said that that's exactly the type of, the amount of alcohol I thought one person would bring if they were going to go to a motel and get drunk for a few days. I mean, Maura Murray had told her university professors at UMass Amherst that she was dealing with a family emergency, that she would be gone for a week. And it's possible that she indeed did just try to get away for 5 days to go to a place that was familiar. And other people have even said this in the past, that Maura Murray was the kind of person that would skip school and get on the train and go to the city, that this was not out of the ordinary for her, that her personality was the type of person who would be a fan of getaways and such. But in terms of planning and plotting a disappearance, and this is all staged and this is all orchestrated, and that she confided in her friend Kate Markopoulos, I would say that it's horribly unlikely that there are that she saw the movie Bottle Rocket in 1996 and then thought, these three bumbling buffoons concocted an escape plan that didn't work, so I'm going to use this movie as an inspiration, and I'm going to do one better, and I'm going to run away and start a new life somewhere. But what I can say about that is that it's just, I really veered away from the suicide and the tandem driver theory, or that Maura was running away to just start a new life somewhere. I mean, it sounds like she was dealing with an enormous amount of emotional stress, an enormous amount of pressure, and that everything just reached a breaking point after she got into her second car accident over a span of a series of days. The first one was involved with wrecking her father, Fred Murray's car, and they, of course, stayed in a motel, and he tried to buy her a new one. But it's just that when you look at the disappearance of Maura Murray, I think a lot of people were just really pulled in and captivated by the possibility that there could be this disappearance, this missing persons case. Yet somehow, some way, Maura would still be alive. I really think that that was something that just kind of mesmerized people. Because I've said very clearly from the beginning, we know a lot about what happened prior to Route 112, the road she was driving on at the time when she had the accident, and zero after. She just vanished. But it's most likely that Maura Murray did enter into somebody's car. And, I mean, I say that because a lot of people have said that she most likely would have left some physical evidence behind, and if they've even found some footprints in the snow or walking down the side of the road, not walking into the forest. I mean, she knew she wouldn't leave footprints walking into the forest, but it's most likely she walked down the side of the road for about 100 meters, and then she entered into somebody's vehicle. For years, I thought that this was just the case of this person died in the woods. Maura died in the woods. Somebody left that comment on Missing Maura Murray once, where they just said, "Where's the mystery? This girl died in the woods," and just simply they were unable to reclaim her body, or they just find out where the location of her body was. I mean, there's some things that tie into that. When a person is running, the risk of freezing to death is much higher. Maura was a cross-country runner. Another thing is, if she were intoxicated, we all know that your body temperature goes down. You're not supposed to drink alcohol in the cold. You feel warmer, but it's actually making you colder. It just dries out your skin. That could be another thing. But I think that greatly rules out the possibility that there are any clues in this movie Bottle Rocket. I'm not sure how widely discussed that is. I was really trying to find more things in the past that I could cross-reference with to see that this is something that is, you know, this is like something widely discussed. I couldn't even see the person that told, like, where is he getting this source that Maura Murray said one of her favorite movies was Bottle Rocket? Maybe the Missing Maura Murray guys have said something, but I really began to dislike their presentation after about 25 episodes, and by 30, I had lost my place, and I couldn't remember where I was, so I steered away from their show. But they kept on going, like, even just one time when I saw that their episodes were approaching the triple digits. Lance and Tim, of course, were the guys behind Crawl Space. But what I would say about Maura Murray is that this particular case is something that is very alluring, very captivating. And I really think that a lot of people get pulled into it, more into this one, much more so than other missing persons cases because of the ability to speculate. But until we recover some skeletal remains of Maura, it's most likely we will never know what happened. The dirtbag theory, the person that may have either abducted her or tried to give her a ride somewhere, could have done something to her. Or originally, what I thought was that she would have entered somebody's vehicle. That person would have driven her maybe 3 or 4 miles away. I mean, 3 or 4 miles outside of the search radius, to be very precise, because they scoured the area around the car. Or like, and I mean, it's been searched over the years as well. 3 or 4 miles out of the search radius area, maybe even 10, 15 miles to another wooded area, and then Maura took off into the night, and that's where she passed away. That was like the biggest thing that I was going with in the past. However, I don't have any certainty of it. And when it comes to this type of crime, or this type of incident in true crime, the missing persons cases, I really veered away from a lot of them, because it's so easy to speculate. But after putting out many uploads on the channel, I really found that simply just speculating and just saying, here's what I think happened, often leads you down a pathway that is not very justifiable. And you'll often find that the theories that you concoct are easily proven wrong. I've been wrong so many times. So we've really began to approach the channel in a different way and just look at more of, like, not only the psychological aspects of the case when we're dealing with serial killers, but how does this stuff begin to affect things in a social context, as well as just reviewing some of the literature, episodes, books, documentaries, talking about their presentation of the subjects. Because I don't know what happened to Maura Murray, and I can speculate to the end of time, but that's not the most effective way to get answers. However, though, I would say that if there are going to be people spreading disinfo on the internet and say that Maura was a big fan of the movie Bottle Rocket, that she used this story of Owen Wilson, Luke Wilson, and some other guy whose name is Bob in the film, not sure his real name, about how these guys are just concocting this plan to run away and start a new life and just have it all go haywire, so then they just give up 30 minutes into the film. I don't really think that's very plausible. I don't think that that is something that would have genuinely happened. I mean, I was really hoping that there would have been more substance in the movie. And that's, like I said, the first time I ever heard about it was from something talking about Maura Murray. I've always wanted to see Bottle Rocket so I could put it in context to the missing Maura Murray case, to the disappearance of Maura Murray, that is. And I really have to tell you, I was disappointed that there wasn't more of more substance material that we could attack. I thought it was an excellent film. Absolutely hilarious. And if you ever get a chance to watch Bottle Rocket, I think the meaning of the film could be summed up in one sentence, no spoilers. Out of love, he let him find his own way. Out of love, he let him find his own way. But other than watching an entertaining comedy, it was really a difficult stretch to see anything that could have been a major similarity between the movie and the real Maura Murray case. But if anyone has anything to say at all about the disappearance of Maura Murray from 2004, please drop a comment below. If you like this upload, you can hit the like button. And if you haven't subscribed yet, you're welcome to do so. But most importantly, please drop a comment below. And until next time.